Good afternoon. My name is Amy Hess, the special agent in charge of the FBI's Louisville Field Office, which covers the Commonwealth of Kentucky. As you'll recall, we held a press conference in June to announce that Eric Christopher Kahn had fled sentencing and further prosecution for defrauding the United States government and violating the trust that others had placed in him to serve their best interests. The fraud investigation was conducted by the FBI, the Office of Inspector General for both the Social Security Administration and the Department of Health and Human Services, the Internal Revenue Service's Criminal Investigative Division, and the Department of Justice. Our investigation revealed that over a 10-year period, attorney Eric C. Kahn, Social Security Administrative Law Judge David B. Dougherty, clinical psychologist Alfred Bradley Atkins, and others conspired to have disability benefits awarded to more than 1,700 claimants, regardless of their status. These fraudulent submissions would have exceeded $550 million in lifetime benefits from the Social Security Administration. Mr. Kahn, Judge Dougherty, and Dr. Atkins were all indicted for their roles in this conspiracy in April of 2016. After negotiations, Mr. Kahn pled guilty to charges of theft of government property and payment of illegal gratuities. He agreed to the forfeiture of $5.7 million in fees and $46.5 million restitution to the Social Security Administration. While awaiting sentencing, Mr. Kahn was released from custody with the condition that he wear an electronic monitoring anklet and remain in his home except for pre-approved outings. In May of this year, Judge Dougherty pled guilty to accepting illegal gratuities. He was sentenced in August to 4 years imprisonment, restitution of $93 million, and agreed to forfeit $609,000. In June, Dr. Atkins was convicted by a jury of conspiracy, mail fraud, wire fraud, and making a false statement. He was sentenced in September to 25 years imprisonment, restitution of $93 million, and forfeiture of $187,600. Mr. Kahn was expected to testify in Dr. Atkins' trial. However, on June 2nd, Eric Kahn, the main defendant in this case, cut off his electronic monitoring anklet and fled custody, thereby violating the terms of his release, his plea agreement, and the obligation to society that he be held accountable for his crimes. In July, Mr. Kahn was sentenced in absentia to 12 years imprisonment, restitution of nearly $107 million, and forfeiture in the amount of $5.7 million. The sentence was solely based on the two charges to which he had previously pled guilty. The other April 2016 charges against him remain pending. In October, we announced that Mr. Kahn had been indicted by a federal grand jury for conspiracy to escape, conspiracy to fail to appear, and failure to appear. Additionally, we announced an associate of Mr. Kahn, Curtis Lee Wyatt, was also indicted for conspiracy to escape, instigating, aiding, and assisting escape, conspiracy to fail to appear, aiding and abetting failure to appear, and making false statements. Since Mr. Kahn's escape, the FBI has been working diligently with numerous agencies to find Mr. Kahn and bring him back to Kentucky. These agencies include those previously mentioned, as well as U.S. Probation, the U.S. Marshals Service, U.S. Customs and Border Protection, the Kentucky State Police, Lexington Police, Pikeville Police, University of Kentucky Police, and the Luna County, New Mexico Sheriff's Office. We also work closely with various FBI field offices, FBI headquarters divisions, and FBI legal attaché offices in multiple countries, particularly those in Mexico City and San Salvador, as well as our international law enforcement partners. We pursued all investigative avenues. We interviewed dozens of people, to include Mr. Kahn's family, friends, and associates. We employed various technical capabilities. We reviewed emails and social media posts purportedly originating from Mr. Kahn. We conducted analysis of his finances and seized bank accounts. We conducted physical surveillance. We searched his former law office, vehicle, and the residence of his mother in Stanville, Kentucky. And we offered a reward for information leading directly to his arrest. In sum, as I explained at the last press conference, we would bring all available resources to bear to find Mr. Kahn and bring him to justice, to hold him accountable for the lives he impacted and the trust he betrayed. We implored him to cooperate in order to best serve the community that he once was a part of and to bring him in safely. He refused to do so. Today, I'm pleased to announce that Mr. Khan is in custody. On Saturday, December 2nd, with the assistance of the FBI's legal attaché in San Salvador and La Agencia Técnica de Investigación Criminal, or ATIC, Mr. Khan was arrested without incident at a Pizza Hut in La Ceiba, Honduras. A photograph of Mr. Khan at the time of his arrest is being provided to you. Mr. Khan is currently in custody of FBI agents, and at some point soon, he'll appear in court to face the remaining charges against him. As promised, Mr. Khan will now be held accountable for his actions, the people he deceived, and the lives he shattered, including all the victims of his greed in eastern Kentucky. I'd now like to introduce Tracy Montano, Special Agent in Charge of the IRS CID out of Nashville.
Good afternoon. I just wanted to acknowledge, as you heard, all the different agencies that came together to apprehend. We worked together tirelessly to investigate, to prosecute, and to apprehend those individuals that look to enrich themselves by fraudulent means. I'd also like to recognize the excellent work of IRS criminal investigation special agents, who are a key component to financial crimes such as these, where they look to defraud the American taxpayer. So I'm happy to be a part of this, and I wanted to say thank you to all those special agents that worked tirelessly to bring us to this day. Thank you.
And Michael McGill, Special Agent in Charge of Social Security Administration, OIG.
The Social Security Administration's OIG applauds the diligent efforts of the United States Department of Justice's Criminal Division and Money Laundering and Asset Recovery Sections, along with our friends with the FBI, who have done an amazing job locating this fugitive. Earlier this year, Mr. Khan pleaded guilty to leading a multi-million dollar Social Security fraud scheme for several years in Kentucky and West Virginia. Despite his best efforts to escape justice, Mr. Khan will ultimately be held accountable for his actions. On behalf of the Social Security OIG, I thank and commend all of our law enforcement partners for their assistance during the criminal investigation of Mr. Khan's scheme and their subsequent efforts to locate and apprehend Mr. Khan. Thank you.
Thank you. And in conclusion, we again just want to thank all the agencies who were mentioned here today, as well as the public and all those individuals who cooperated with us in this investigation to ensure Mr. Khan is brought to justice. Thank you.